would like to start asking you which role do you see for social networking in the future evolution of the movements in the Arabic countries, the social movements?
Well, the social movements have not ended, and so they started almost 2 years ago, but still they are taking place even in countries that saw a change of government. Unfortunately, after the change in these governments, the governments have not allowed more press freedom. In fact, they are jailing people for posting on social media. They are jailing people they're not giving them freedom of expression. And so when you don't have freedom of expression in the official media, TV, radio, newspapers, people will ultimately turn to social media. So it is a very important tool for people to say what they think.
I would like to ask you your opinion about the recent outcomes, the possible future outcomes and the evolution which occurred in Egypt, as long as you wrote a lot about the Egyptian condition.
Well, honestly, we will know by the end of the year or early next year there is going to be parliamentary elections, and Egypt has a very strong parliament. So the parliament introduces legislation and laws. I think when we see the makeup of the parliament, is it going to be more Islamist? Is it going to be secular? What Islamist? Because you know you have two or three different kinds of Islamists. So which Islamist will it be, the moderates or the extremists? And so then you will be able to judge how things will move forward in the next 4 years. But Egypt is a very vital country to the region. Anything that happens in Egypt will affect the whole Middle East because of their rich cultural, artistic, intellectual capacity. They are influencing all the Arab world.
Do you believe that there are some foreign players which are conducting a role in the area, in the evolution of the countries of the area, in the evolution of social movements, and that they are not playing a so public role? Do you think there are some countries like
this? No doubt that there are foreign players, because it is such a vital part of the world. It is a part of the Arab world is very oil rich. Part of it is very strategic. The Suez Canal, for example, there are Israel is bordering several Arab countries, and so it is for the world community. It is a very important matter. I would be surprised if they were not trying to get involved. Sometimes they get involved financially, as we see the Gulf getting involved in Syria, in Egypt, in Tunisia through funding, or they get involved militarily, like in Libya, like in Yemen. So there is definitely not only international players, but also the countries of the region are trying to interfere in each other's.
The mainstream media, the Western world especially, are keep on speaking about an Arab autumn or an Arab winter. What's your view about this developed mainstream opinion?
Well, my opinion is that the Arab uprisings, sometimes referred to as the Arab Spring, is really a generational shift. It is not something that will take place and tomorrow the world will be better. You're talking about countries that for 60 years were repressive. There is no civil society, no freedom of expression, no women's rights, no children's rights, no human rights. So it will not be overnight. You're looking at maybe in 10 years that you will see the result. For me, the measure is, will the next president of Egypt step down democratically, or will he try to say, like Hugo Chavez, for example, I want to extend another 4 years, give me an extra four. So you will only see when there is a peaceful transfer of power.
Thank you so much. To start asking you about your role in the Bahrain Center for Human Rights and the Gulf Center for Human Rights.
Of course. I am the acting president of the Bahrain Center for Human Rights. Our current president is in prison. He was sentenced to 3 years imprisonment on the charges of illegal gathering. And he started a hunger strike, a dry hunger strike yesterday, which means no water, food, or medication. And I'm the deputy director of the Gulf Center for Human Rights.
I would like to ask you, which kind of evolution do you see, if you see some possible evolution in the Bahrain social movement, also in front of the foreign interests, such as the Saudi and the American ones?
Well, I think, you know, once a population decides that they have the right to self-determination, they decide that they're going to fight for their freedoms and democracy no matter what, then they're going to achieve it. It might take a lot longer in Bahrain than other places because they're facing so much resistance from the outside and from the inside. But I think at the end of the day, there's no government that can outlast its people. And so if people in Bahrain decide that they're going to continue protesting, continue demanding, no matter what the price is, even if they're being ignored by the entire world, then I think they will achieve a change.
A lot of people are saying about now that we are going to experience an Arab autumn and Arab winter. Which is your perspective about the evolution, this evolution, 1 year after the movement in Egypt, Tunisia and so on?
Well, I think, you know, it's this idea of the protests turning bad. I think that's something that we kind of saw coming. These are oppressive regimes that have been supported by many different countries for a very long time, so they're very powerful. Of course, they're going to keep oppressing people. Of course, they're going to keep killing people. Now, the question is, are we going to be able to get enough international support to make sure it doesn't last too long? That's the question.
Thank you so much.
Of course, no problem. Thank you.